Welcome to Hydraulic Press Channel. Today we are going to crush some big ass bearing balls. So the same idea as last week, but this time we have some help from liquid nitrogen. This is going to make anything more brittle and more explodive when crushed. And also it's interesting to see, are we going to see the same super hot, red hot surface of bearing ball when it explodes? And now I have also second high speed camera running with higher frame rate so we can get more detail of the explosion itself. And here we go with the first one, 20 millimeters. We run out of time. One of the nuts didn't attach to the polycarbonate. And I said that it doesn't need it. So it's like that. And also the tool dropped down. So pretty good start for the day. Okay, then the next one. And this is the one that made this crazy red ball thing. But now it's extremely cold when it goes in. So really interesting to see what happens. At least these are now much weaker than last time. Okay, it's a bit harder. What the hell? How it's so strong this time? It should be weaker. Okay. What is going on? I think we broke our tools. Did the tool get so much weaker? Or the ball stronger? What the hell? Okay, what the hell is going on? Okay, this is going on. What the hell? Seems that the ball is not round anymore. At least it didn't get hot. It's really cold still, or is it? Sometimes it takes... Yeah, it's like, it's cold, all right. I get measurement device and let's check is the ball anymore round. I think it looks a little bit not round.
Okay, and I was so surprised because the first ball bearing, it was like half as strong as last time. And also the hammers on older video, they explode much easier with liquid nitrogen. But my friend who knows more about hardening told that there is this method called cryogenic hardening. And sometimes after regular hardening and like heat treatment, all that stuff, there is still some austenite in like hardened steel. And with cryogenic hardening, you can get rid of that by just cooling the part with liquid nitrogen. And that increases the part's strength and hardness. And it also might be just that the balls get somehow stronger when you cool them down. But one thing is sure, that they're going to get much weaker when you heat it up until it's red hot. So I want to try also that. And one thing to note about red hot steel and this filming setup is the fact that the red hot steel isn't actually red. It's the same color as always. It just emits red light. And our super bright filming lights easily outshine that red, so it looks just regular ball even when it's red hot.
Yeah, it cooled down surprisingly fast. I think you need like proper gas furnace to get them like red hot. I think we have special guest coming up soon. I found out while cleaning the workshop, I found out the ceramic ball bearing and we destroyed our hardened tools, but We're going to try with these. I want one last crush. And these are way harder than steel, even when they are way lighter. So really interesting to see what kind of dents it makes in the tool. Or will it even explode? You never know. But we are going to find out. Okay, here we go. Can't be that bad. Okay. Okay, it didn't explode. Oh, that was still exciting. Check out that dent. That's pretty decent.
And the most of the comments on last week's video were about getting better high-speed camera or doing the collab with slow-mo guys. And we had much better cameras with the press. Actually the same cameras that the slow-mo guys used to use a lot, the V2512. This is really fast camera. Much faster than our Kronos cameras. I don't remember how fast we filmed, but the clips are here. Like really, really fast compared to last week's video, like 100 times faster. And the problem with these cameras is the fact that I don't have one. And the second fact is that they are really expensive to rent. And usually if you have better cameras, it doesn't turn into views on my channel. So if I'm going to rent one, it's going to come out of my own pocket. I'm not going to get the money back from like more views or anything like that. Maybe if I have good sponsor for the channel, I could use like the sponsor budget and some of my own money to get that. Or then if the slow-mo guys want to come, it's of course pretty long trip to Finland. But if you guys want to check this, I'm really glad to do it again. We have crushed just smaller ball bearings last time. We didn't have so good safety planning. So these are not as explodey as the big one were. And also we filmed something like 6 videos in a day. So the clips are not framed perfectly and the settings are not good and the cameras are nowadays even better. So with like that 30mm and even maybe larger ball bearings, more time, better cameras, I think we could solve the mystery of what that red frame was. But as you can see, even like these old clips are pretty nice. So enjoy these and I leave link to this video in down in the description. And that is all for today. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.